All right, now we'll get to the hindquarter and show you how we cut a hindquarter up. First, we start by cutting the flank off. Here. Those of you that like flank steak, there is one flank steak in a side of beef, and that flank steak is right here. That is your flank steak. Some people like skirt steaks. Good place, if you can see this right here, this is where we would get a good skirt steak for you. Probably the best of the skirt steak is right here. There's a little bit left right in here if you want some skirt steaks also. What do you do with skirt steaks? A lot of people like to grill them and then slice it thin and use it for our fajitas. Same thing with the flank steak. You would take that flank steak, grill it till it's just about done, and then cut it. The grain runs this way, slice it thin, use it for fajitas. If you don't use it for anything, it goes into hamburgers, just like everything else. Here is the kidney and the kidney fat. Pull that back. Take all that off. Push that again. Clean this up a little bit. Flip that hind quarter. Again, this might not be how a lot of guys do it, but this is how we do it, and it's been working for about 100 years now, so if it ain't broke, we ain't gonna fix it. Get this all trimmed up. And then we start cutting sirloin steaks from this end. Throw this over for hamburger. Now we'll trim this round up. And here's where your sirloin tip or tri-tip will come from, this piece of meat right here. And most people don't like a lot of fat on their beef. I am one of them. Like to trim as much of the gobbledygook off as we can. Makes a nice lean cut of meat. Oh, good enough. Now, we'll go in here and cut the tip out, the tri-tip or the sirloin tip. Trim that up later, and now this little baby's ready to cut round steaks out. Put it on the saw. This is where your rolled rump rolls will come from. this up a little bit. Makes a prettier brown steak for you. Normally they're cut half inch thick. We can run them through the tenderizer, or you can have them just the way they come. Some people don't like round steak, so we'll just throw it in the hamburger. You can make round steaks, you can make stew meat out of it. If you want stir fry, sometimes we can use the top. Right here is the top round, this part. Makes great stir fry if you want to slice it up thin. Makes great roast if you want to, if you want to make Italian beef or something like that. And again, this is if you don't like round steak. Right here is the eye of the round. And it goes back this way about yay long. Then this is the other part of the bottom. Bottom round has this part. That's what we call it. They want round steak, so that's what we're going to get.
Out. I like to cut that little star pad out here. like that, make it look pretty. Zoom that off there a little bit, just like that. That makes it very nice looking sirloin like that. Notice every cut that I make, that bone gets longer and longer and longer. And that is just about the end of the sirloin. As you can see how big the bone is right here compared to where it was back here. Thank you. is what's in the hindquarters.